So you're thinking of starting your own business, but you're worried that you don't really know what to expect and that everybody's told you that it's going to be easy, it's going to be simple, you know, press this magic button here, take this magic pill and you'll be successful. Like, that's just not true. And in this video, I'm going to go into 4 really important points and topics that you need to be aware of when it comes to starting your own business. This is essentially the unadulterated truth of what it really takes to be successful running your own business. Some people will like it, some people won't. This is the truth that you need to hear. Now, after literally helping hundreds of people, particularly expats, start and grow their own online business, I know what the trials, the challenges, the tribulations, I know what they are, and I know that it can be very difficult. And so I'm just gonna give you the truth and pull back the curtain and tell you what's gonna happen when you try to start a business, what you need to prepare yourself for, and what you need to be prepared for moving forward so that you're ready to tackle the challenge, the life-changing challenge, but the challenge of starting your very own business. So if it's so tough, why do people go through these challenges at all? Well, there's only really one way to gain full control over your own time, to gain full control over your own income, and to gain full control over where in the world you live, and that's to start your very own business. Now, I'm just about to jump onto my whiteboard where I'm going to take you through 4 key points that you really need to know before diving in to start your very own business. Now look, I know there's a lot of people out there who would literally tell you anything just to get you to buy their stuff. So I hope that you're gonna enjoy this video where I'm literally gonna pull back the curtain and reveal the unadulterated truth that you really need to know before deciding whether or not you're gonna start your own business. Now, if you enjoy content like this and you enjoy content that's gonna help you start and grow your own business, or just help you with the mindset of becoming successful, then hit the like button, drop me a comment below, and make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Now, throughout this video, I'm gonna take you through what I believe are the 4 biggest truths or 4 biggest things that you need to know when considering whether or not you should start your very own business. Now, number 4 is arguably my favorite, so make sure you stick around until the end. And after I've been through these 4 and you're still keen to start your own business, I'm then gonna take you through what I believe to be the best, the most effective business model that you can apply as long as you're happy to go through these 4 truths in your journey to success. Now look, point number 1 is something that all of the gurus in the world would really hate for me to unveil to you, but I believe it's so, so important. Magic pill. There is no magic pill for starting your own business. There's nothing you can instantly swallow. There's nothing you can instantly learn that's gonna make you successful in business. Now, many, many people will want you to believe that there is a magic pill, something that you can do that's very easy, very simple, very quick, that you can just apply literally overnight to find success in your own business. Now, this just simply isn't true. And yes, I'm going to upset many people by saying this, because you may well have been suckered into those lies that there's literally a switch that you can flick and instantly get success. Now, starting your own business takes time. Why does it take time? Because you need to learn the right skill sets. Not only do you need to learn the right skill sets, but you then need to spend time and get real world experience developing and refining these skill sets. Because a lot of the skill sets that you need to learn to start your own business, they take practice. And in order to practice a skill set, you first of all need to learn them, you then need to go out into the world to apply them, and you need to persist with them until you actually get good. And it's not until that point of where you actually get good that you'll actually start making some money. So no, there absolutely is no magic pill. So if you're looking for a magic pill, I literally beg you to stop, open your eyes, see the world for what it really is, and realize that starting your own business does not happen overnight. Now, that does not mean that it has to take months or even years to see success. If you've got a good coach and a good mentor, a good system, a good process to follow, and you actually show up and you do the work, it's not unusual to see success and progress, especially financially in your own business, in just a few short weeks. That again is something that I've helped literally hundreds of expats and people wanting to start their own business achieve. And that leads me on to point number two, and that is that starting your own business is hard. So if anybody's ever told you that starting your own business is easy and that, you know, again, it's going to happen overnight and that it's really quick, they're lying. They're lying to you. Starting your own business is hard. Again, going back to the point of learning skills, it takes time to get good at these skills. Now, many people want to give up. When they start something, when they try something, they try and do it, they realize they're not very good, and they think, oh my God, it's gonna take ages for me to actually make any progress and to actually get any form of results and to actually make any money. And many of them quit, right? And that's obviously not something that I want you to even think about doing, which is why I'm preparing you with this list so you know what you're going into. It's hard. And what do I mean by hard? Well, it's not easy. It's not quick. It's gonna take time to refine those skills. Now, what most people struggle with is having the right mindset and expectations going into their own business, to realize that you're gonna fail, you're gonna get things wrong many, many more times than you're gonna get them right, especially when you first get started. Think back to when you first started to learn to walk, when you're a little baby. I'm sure probably you can't actually remember those days. But the principle that the only way you learn to walk is by standing up on your own two feet, by letting go of everything, and by trying to actually take those first few steps. And what happens to all babies when they're first learning to walk? They all fall down. They all bang their bum. They all, you know, get bruises. And this is because you need to fall down to learn the lesson of how to actually hold yourself upright, of how to be successful in your own business. So if you're expecting starting a business to be easy, regardless of how big your ego is, and regardless of the previous experience that you've got in entrepreneurship and in business, you're going to be very, very unpleasantly surprised when you realize that starting a business is actually takes a lot of hard work. And thus we come nicely onto point number three, and that is challenges. Now, you need to fully expect when you go into starting your own business that you're going to experience challenges. Not infrequently, not every week, every single day. Being an entrepreneur is about tackling and facing challenges head on and expecting them to come every single day. Literally a day doesn't go by when you're a successful entrepreneur that you don't face challenges. The likelihood is if you're an unsuccessful entrepreneur, it's because you've been unable to face and tackle the challenges and persist for long enough to learn the skills, to develop the skills, to get good at conquering the challenges that you're gonna have to face as an entrepreneur. You know, entrepreneurship to me is literally about tackling challenges, facing a new challenge every day, addressing it, overcoming it, and getting good at solving challenges. And the reason why most people fail when they try to start their own business is because they're unprepared for the challenges that lay ahead. They think it's gonna be a walk in the park, right? Not hard. They think that they're gonna be able to take a pill and it's gonna happen overnight. And then when they actually face the reality of getting up every day and seeing that there's something else on fire, something else they need to put out, something, you know, in the line of work that I work in, an advertising campaign is not firing. You're struggling to book calls with prospective clients. And you're attending calls and maybe you're just not able to close them. These are the kind of daily challenges that you can expect to face when starting your own client-based digital advertising business. Now, when I first got started out in my entrepreneurial journey, I did not expect the volume of sheer challenges that are going to be on my plate every single day. And this was something that took me by surprise. So by sharing this with you, a lesson that I've learned along my multiple seven-figure journey in entrepreneurship is that you need to be prepared and willing to face challenges every single day, because that is what it takes to hone your craft, refine your skills, and actually get good. And point number four, truth number four, that you really need to learn and pay attention to right now, and this one is literally game changing. This will help you massively as an entrepreneur when we cover this point here, and that is that you are gonna be and you are, the biggest challenge that you face, the biggest obstacle that is currently in your path to becoming successful, it's not the weather, it's not a skill set, it's not anything around you, it's you, it's your mind. All of those times that you thought about starting a business and you've doubted yourself, you've doubted somebody who's going to show you, you've doubted anything, these are all a perfect example of how you are the biggest obstacle to being successful. It's your mindset. It's learning to think like a successful entrepreneur. I've got a video on that one as well. I'll probably link it to this video at the end of here of how to become a successful entrepreneur. It's about the way you think. Now, spoiler alert, Jeff Bezos, Elon Musk, you know, Richard Branson, the big name entrepreneurs, do you really think they think like ordinary people, like average people working day jobs? No, of course they don't. They have their own mindset. They have a way of thinking that has elevated them from pretty much nothing in most cases to having very, very successful international businesses and corporations. It's because they think like a different person. Now, every time you think in your own mind that you can't do something, that something's not going to work, that you're going to fail, that's a perfect example of how you are already stopping yourself from becoming successful. Now, when you do decide to take the leap and start your own business, that problem is not going to go away without the right help. And it is going to take time to overcome your own inner demons. And that's the importance of working with a coach, working with somebody who's already helped many hundreds of people overcome the biggest challenge that they face. And that's thinking like the successful entrepreneur, the successful business person that you want to become. So if you've ever felt doubt, self-doubt, doubt in other people, doubt in a process, doubt in a business model, doubt in yourself that you can actually get a result, that is the surefire sign that if you really want to become successful, if you really want to start your own business, you need help with this. You need help with your mind. You need to learn how to think like a successful entrepreneur. So there we've got it, really. These are the four key points. There is no magic pills. There is no miracle formulas. There's no miracle cures. There's no magic switches that you can flick to become successful in your own business. It's hard, right? Starting your own business is not easy. It's going to be one of the hardest things that you've ever done. So why do people do it? I'm going to come back to that in just a minute. Challenges. You're going to face challenges every single day. And if you're not facing challenges every day, you're not doing what you need to do to achieve the success that you want to achieve with your own successful business. And number four is you. You are the biggest challenge and the biggest obstacle that you're going to face. What's in your mind has a massive impact on whether you are successful or not. So becoming aware of that and learning that you need to change the way you think in order to become the successful business person, the successful entrepreneur that you want to become, this is very important. So that begs the question, why the hell does anybody want to trade their life tackling challenges, doing something that's really hard in starting their own business? Why? Why go through all that trials and tribulations and torment? Well, if you want to live a life of time, financial, and location independence, like many people do who are following and watching my channel, this is the only way to do it. It's by building and starting your very own business. Now, if you've enjoyed this video, if you enjoy this content, remember to hit like, leave me a comment, and subscribe to my channel where I'm bringing out 2, 3, 4, 5 videos like this per week to help you start your very own business. So is going through all of those challenges and personal transformation, is it worth it? Well, you have to ask yourself, how much do you actually want to be able to control how much money you make, to be able to control whereabouts in the world you go, and to be able to control what you do at any set point of the day? If those things are really, really important to you, then starting your own business is literally going to be one of the best things that you've ever done. But if those things aren't important to you and your why isn't strong enough, like why do you want to put in this work? Why do you want to be successful? If that why isn't strong enough, then do yourself a favor and don't start your own business just yet. And if you want help with anything that you've seen in this video, then I'll drop a link in the comments below and you can book a time to speak with one of my coaching team to see whether or not we can help you start your very own business working for yourself. And remember, at the end of all of those hard, challenging times is the ultimate result that you really want to achieve. And that's being able to do what you want, when you want, wherever you want, and not have to answer to a boss or trade another second working a job that maybe you don't even enjoy. Thank you very much for watching this video. Remember, hit subscribe, hit like, drop me a comment below. Let me know your thoughts on entrepreneurship, your challenges, and I will respond to every single comment that is below. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed this video. Peace out, have a wicked week.